Hey guys, John from FlyMyKelf.com, and today I'm going to talk to you about how to use the VOR receiver in your airplane when you're in the airplane. So when you're actually going out for a flight lesson, maybe flight lesson 6 or 8 or 10, or whenever your instructor decides to introduce the VOR to you, you'll be ready to know how to use it and how to use it to navigate to where you want to go. So for starters here, let's say we hop in our airplane, we're flying out of the Venice airport, and we want to fly to Sarasota. Well, obviously we could just follow the coast, but let's say we're in the middle of the country and we don't have a convenient coastline to follow, we want to use the VOR to do so. Well, we're going to use the VOR, and we're going to use the frequency of 117.0 in that VOR box there. We're going to dial that into our nav radio, make sure that's in the active part of our frequency, so if we put it in the standby, we'll switch it over to be active. And then we could actually go ahead and tune up the VOR and listen to it, listen to the Morse code, and make sure we're getting the right reception from the VOR. And your instructor will show you how to listen to the Morse code in the airplane, because it's a little different in each aircraft. But in any case, we've got 117.0 dialed up, and we are down to the southeast of the VOR. So here's our little airplane. There's the Sarasota VOR, and we're southeast of it. We want to get to it. Let's say we don't know. Even if we're southeast or southwest or wherever we are, doesn't matter. We don't have to know where we are. All we have to do is have that frequency dialed in and then take our OBS knob, our omnibearing selector, and start twisting it around to where we can get a 2 flag. And so we have that 2 flag here. And then we want to center up our needle. So we're just twisting that around. We can see the outer ring turning and changing its heading there, the numbers there. As we're twisting this OBS knob, the needle becomes centered with a 2 indication, and we simply have to fly that heading roughly about 325 or so, and that'll take us to the station. We can see that we have dialed up here the 324 radial outbound from the station, and we're actually located on the 144 radial from the station right now. So we can see our heading, we're kind of turned off heading to the northeast. We want to fly a heading of 325 to get to the station. And if we just keep flying the current heading that we're on, we're going to notice that the needle starts to kind of come off a little bit, showing us, hey, the course is to your left. You need to fly this heading. And so we look up here to our DG, and we'll actually go ahead and turn our aircraft and start flying a heading of 325 to get back to our radial inbound to fly to the station. Now, as we make this turn and we get roughly towards, 325 or so there, we'll go ahead and level our wings, fly straight, and then we could go ahead and just twist this again to recenter the knob and fly that heading. So I'm getting roughly in the neighborhood of 330 or so. I'm gonna go ahead and start to roll out, level my wings here. And as our wings are level, we're flying straight. Now, I want to go ahead and center up my CDI again. So I'm just going to go ahead and twist that around. I got the CDI centered on about 320. That means I need about a 320 heading. You can see how we have that slight diverging angle there. So if I bank a little more to the left and fly a heading of 320, I'll be perfectly lined up to go to the station. So no matter where we are when we start, we can always find our way back to the station just by twisting the OBS, getting a 2 flag, and getting the needle centered. Then once we have the needle centered, whatever heading we see depicted at the top here, we want to fly roughly that heading. We're about a 315 heading here, so I'll go ahead and turn a little bit back to a 320 heading. Seeing the needle going just slightly to the right there means we want to turn slightly to the right to go get it. So whenever you have a 2 flag, you have positive sensing. If the needle goes right, you turn to the right to go get the needle and bring it back. So if I turn off to the left here, and we'll speed up just to make this happen a little faster. If I turn my aircraft off to the left, we're going to notice the needle go to the right because it's saying, hey, your course is off to your right. So now I want to go ahead and go back to the right to center up the needle. We see it drifting off to the right there. And now I'm turning the airplane back to the right. And as we get past that 320, so we're not paralleling it now, we have an intercept going on. We're turning 330, 340. I'll give myself about a 20-degree intercept to it. Then we're going to see the needle start coming back to the center. And as the needle recenters, then we'll go ahead and fly as close to this heading as we can. Now, you may have a wind coming from, say, like your left there, and you or a wind from the right where you actually have to crab the airplane and fly a heading of 350 to hold a ground track of 320. Because remember, the VOR is a ground-based station, and it's really these radials are fixed in position, so it's a ground track that it's referencing. So that's how we could get to the station. Now let's go ahead and say that we want to find out what radial we're on from the station. The instructor says, hey, what radial are you on from the station, or where are you relative to the station? So let's just pretend we don't know where our airplane is right now. And I'm just going to move it around here to some random place. And so we notice we have a from flag, and we want to go ahead and find out where we are relative to the station, northeast, southeast, southwest, whatever it might be. So I'm going to twist that OBS knob until I have a from indication and the needle centered. If I happen to twist too much and say, you know, we have a to indication, just keep on twisting until you get that from indication. And once you have the from indication, twist a little slower then and get the needle centered up. There we go. So you have a from indication, needle centered, and now we can say where we are from the station. Well, remember, anytime we have a from flag, the number up here is the radial that we are on. So we are on the 340 radial. If you're on the 340 radial from Sarasota, say, you must be somewhere off to the northwest. And we can see, looking at our plan view here, yep, we are in fact to the northwest of the station. Now, what if we got really fancy here and I told you something like, hey, I want you to go ahead and intercept the 270 radial from the station and track it inbound and then fly on the 090 radial outbound from the station. So that's pretty fancy instruction right there. That's going to really show that you know what's going on. So 270 inbound, the 270 radial inbound. So let's go ahead and dial this guy up here with our OBS knob so that we have 090 on our heading, because ultimately we're going to be flying to the station on the 270 radial inbound and then 090 from the station. So we first dial it up to 090 there, and then we're going to go ahead and fly our present heading to intercept the 270 radial. So we see the to indication, that's good, 090 is good. And we're going to go ahead and stay on that heading there. We'll roll our wings level. And once we start to see this needle moving in, then we can go ahead and start turning to the right, and we'll want to get about a 30-degree intercept, 30 to 45-degree intercept, depending on how far you are from the station. Remember, further you are from the station, the less sensitive this guy is, to then make that right turn and intercept that radial and track it inbound. Now, since we have a to flag, and we're going to be flying to the station, we have positive sensing. Needle's on our left means we have to go left to get it. We can see here, though, we're already at a 90-degree intercept, so going left won't help us anymore. That's about as steep as we can go. We notice 360 is our heading, and that's about 90 degrees off of 090, and about 010 heading now. Need to roll our wings level here. So as we fly this 80-degree intercept or so, that's about as steep as we can get. As we start getting closer, I'm going to start shallowing up my intercept angle so that needle doesn't quick jump to the right and we fly right through it. As we start to turn more towards the station, it'll make a little bit better sense that as the needle's to our left, we'll go left to get the radial, and our needle's to the right, we'll go right to get it. So as we're getting closer here, I'm going to go ahead and start turning to the right. We can see our needle's already moving, and hopefully it's not too late. We might actually shoot right through this, because I should have had a shallower intercept as I approach the radial. And I'll roll over to roughly about a 090 heading up here once I see this needle centered down here. I'll go ahead and shallow my bank now, keep that needle coming in, try to keep that 30-degree intercept or so up here on our heading, now about a 20-degree intercept. And as this needle centers up here, I'm going to go ahead and roll on to a 090 heading and just track that heading inbound. Again, if we had wind, we might actually have to fly a heading of, say, like, you know, 100, if we had a wind coming out of the south, pushing the airplane to the north, to stay on that ground track of 090 to the station on the 270 radial from the station. So remember, the station's made up of 360 radials, and we have the 270 radial sticking out this way, the 090 radial sticking out that way. Even though you have 090 dialed in here, it's 090 to get to the station, not the 090 radial that you're on. You're in fact on the 270 radial. And if you were at all in doubt and wanted to confirm that, remember what we said, we can just twist this guy around to where we get the needle centered with a from flag. And once we get that from flag, we'll just keep spinning here, get our 270 radial centered up there, and yep, from flag, 270, needle centered, we are on the 270 radial, roughly, you know, 272, something close. In VORs, we're not looking for, you know, plus minus 0.1 degrees here. We're giving you a little leeway since they're not that precise. And a fun fact, how precise should your VOR be? Well, we typically accept plus or minus 4 degrees as an error when they're actually testing these VORs on the ground. So when the mechanic tests it and says, yeah, your VOR is working good, he's just testing it to plus or minus 4 degrees for you. So we'll go ahead here and fly inbound on the 270 radial on a 090 heading to cross the VOR and then track outbound on the 090 radial. And the only difference we're going to notice here when we're crossing the station is instead of 090 to the station, it's going to become 090 and the flag's going to flip to from. It's going to be from the station because remember, we're going to be on the 090 radial here soon. And when we're on the 090 radial, we'll have to have that from flag with a needle centered to show us that we are in fact on the 090 radial. Why I keep emphasizing radial here is people often confuse the heading or bearing with radial. The radials are these fixed lines coming out of the VOR station. They never move, they are fixed in place, and you could often reference and say, yeah, sure, the Venice Airport lies on the 167 radial from Sarasota. So if you just go ahead and get this guy tuned up to about 167 at the top there with a from flag, you know you're on the 167 radial from Sarasota. Now you just have to figure out how far are you from Sarasota, and then you can exactly pinpoint where the Venice Airport is and where you are in relation to it. It's safe to say that if you flew over the Sarasota VOR and then flew the 167 radial outbound from Sarasota, 167 from the station, then you would in fact fly directly over the Venice Airport at some point in the future as you fly outbound on that radial. So as we proceed inbound on the 270 radial here with the 090 heading, we can see that our needle's moving a little faster here. As we get closer, it gets much more sensitive the closer you get. And as we cross over, it's gonna flip from to from. Once it does that, I'll go ahead and pause this, and then we'll go ahead and dial it up so that we can actually fly the 167 radial outbound and go ahead and find the Venice Airport somehow. So there's our flip to from. Now we're gonna go ahead and dial this up to fly the 167 radial to get to Venice and make sure we keep positive sensing. So how we're gonna do this is go ahead and dial up 167 in there. And we notice we have a 167 heading here. We're from the station. I'll go ahead and unpause our simulation, and we can see that our needle is off to the right, so we need to turn our aircraft to the right to go get back on that radial. So I'll go ahead and bank us to the right here. And we are turning to the right, and we can see our aircraft's coming back around and eventually going to intercept this radial, and we'll be tracking it outbound, and we have positive sensing because we're flying away from the station, and we have a from flag. So positive sensing is when you're flying away from the station with a from flag, or you're flying to the station and you have a to flag. If it's vice versa, if you're flying from the station with a to flag, then it's reverse sensing, where instead of going right to get our needle centered, we actually have to go left and the needle acts backwards. And a better way to say this might be if your heading on your DG roughly matches what you have on your VOR selector there, the OBS setting, then you have positive sensing. If it's within, say, like plus or minus 30 degrees, really if it's within plus or minus 90, if it's relatively close, then you have positive sensing. You have reverse sensing when it is opposite, 180 degrees opposite to what you have selected. So when you're on a heading of 090, but the VOR selector is set to 270, then you have reverse sensing. So we'll go ahead and fly about this 200 heading here, about a 30 degree intercept. And as we see our needle starting to center up, I'll go ahead and bank a little to the left to go ahead and fly the 167 radial outbound. I'll turn back towards 167 there, and that'll give me a nice smooth intercept onto that radial. See our needle moving there? I'm turning to the left. and we'll intercept and track this 167 radial outbound towards the Venice airport. Now, as we're flying along here, say we get a little off course, and we happen to get blown off to the west side of that radial, well, we're just going to notice that the needle moves through center, and it's going to track over to the left, meaning we have to turn back to the left to go get it. We're turning to the right now, and I'm going to go ahead and turn back to the left, and that's going to bring our needle back to the center. As we see our heading comes back around, the needle will stop diverging. As our airplane comes back around, we'll intercept that course outbound. And now that we have a nice intercept angle going on here with our heading of the aircraft versus the radial that we're dialed into on our OBS, we can see the needle's coming back to center. As it centers up, we'll want to go ahead and turn our aircraft heading back close to this heading here, 167. We'll want to turn our aircraft towards a 167 heading to keep that needle in the center. And then, of course, we'll account for whatever wind correction we might need onto this heading up here. To do a quick recap with you guys here, as we're flying along and we don't know where we are, the instructor's going to say, tell me where you are relative to the station. You're going to say, well, I don't know. So where are you relative to the Sarasota VOR? Well, we're just going to spin our OBS knob. As long as we have our VOR tuned to the Sarasota VOR, we'll spin our OBS knob to get a from flag and center up the needle. Oh, there's a to flag. Keep spinning. There's our from flag. We'll keep on spinning, and we'll spin a little slower as we get close. And as we center up that needle, then we can safely say, okay, we are 170 from the station. We are to the southeast of the station, mostly south. If the instructor says, good, now that you know you're southeast of the station, take me to Sarasota, take me to the station. You'll say, all right, no problem. I'm just going to spin this guy around until I get a to indication, and with the flag in the to position and the needle centered, there's our to indication. There's our needle starting to center. Oops, we went too far. We'll go back a little bit, twist it nice and slow, get that needle centered, and okay, I want to fly about a 335 heading to get to the station. I'm flying a 075 heading right now. Let me go ahead, turn to the left here, and I'll fly a 335 heading to get to the station. And while we're making this turn, sure, the needle gets a little bit out of whack. We could turn and keep going further left instead of flying 335. We could fly a 300 heading to come back around and intercept that radial. Or once you get pointed generally towards the station, you could just twist the OBS again, get the needle centered, read your new heading at the top there, and then fly that heading on your DG. So we're roughly pointed towards the station. I'm going to go ahead and level my wings there. And then I'm just going to go ahead and twist the OBS to get the needle centered up again. And now we can see 325 will take us to the station. I'll fly that heading of about 325. Turn a little to the right here to get back to it. We're on a 320 heading right now. And that'll take us to our station. Well, guys, that's pretty much it for VOR navigation in the airplane. There's not much more complicated than that, at least at the private pilot level. We'll get into a little more advanced stuff for the instrument course and show you some really fancy tricks with the VOR then. In the meantime, make sure you give us a thumbs up on our video, subscribe to our channel so you can keep up with our latest episodes as they come out. We really appreciate you guys watching. Make sure you check out our website and our Patreon page. All the support you guys give us really helps keep this a free program for everyone. As always, if you can't fly every day, then fly at mikealpha.com. We'll see you all next time.